But essentially, so we could see in the not too distant future, essentially information from Wisdom in there as well. So I could, as a patient, be looking at potentially messages from you, from my dental practice, and information on prescriptions and those kind of things.
Yeah, for us, I mean, it's truly exciting, and I don't think I've ever been more excited about liberating some of that data safely. But in terms of you as the patient, can now see if you want to. I mean, let's think about Epic, right? Now approaching 70% of the US population, knowingly or unknowingly, are operating within some component of Epic on their medical journey, right? That's pretty outstanding in terms of that volume. So imagine now you, as that Epic-based patient, can begin to bring the full continuum in, right, of your healthcare information, the traditional PCP, and then, you know, your acute visit information as well, and a multitude of data around that. If you wanted to, like the imaging, the billing, possibly, I mean, more than a lot of folks are utilizing, right, leveraging. Now you add in that full dental journey as well. And you have the pharmaceutical. I mean, it's just you're never going to have the bigger view of your health information.
So, last question: you're starting on the cloud, or are you going to build it out internally and host it?
Wouldn't you be disappointed with me if I said I was going to build it out and host it internally?
Yes, I would. The answer to that is yes, but there are valid reasons, and a lot of them are financial. Some people have said that the cloud model is still a little pricey from Epic. I know this will probably get back to Judy, and I apologize. I don't even know the pricing model. I've just heard this from some clients.
Pricing's relative, I guess, huh?
Well, if you're just starting out, you know, you're not replacing, you're not moving. Some people already have it on site. They already have the equipment. It's already in a data center. They don't have to build anything new out. And then they look at the cloud pricing and they're like, well, why would I do that? I already have all this stuff.
Yeah.
Well, you would do it when that equipment becomes end of life and you have to do something.
Yes, but plus, as you know, forearmed with a ton of information around what it costs to build out the practice management infrastructure, architecture that sits on top of a huge VDI, usually, infrastructure. So forearmed with that, where it's really going to cost to build out to see us into the next 5 years of growth, these things start to normalize, I would say.
You won't see this on camera, but I'm looking over your shoulder seeing a map of all the locations you guys are in.
All right.
And you almost have to be in the cloud if you're going to be servicing that kind of geography.
Yeah, we're so distributed, right, that that's important, especially from even a latency standpoint, if you like, that we're that we're set up in a good distributed way across the country.